If you're looking for a budget audio interface for your home studio, the Behringer Euphoria UM2 can be a great option. I'm going to give you 8 Behringer UM2 tips plus one extra tip coming up. Welcome to Simple Green Tech. I'm Radio Zane, and I do weekly videos with tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you unleash your creativity. In this video, I'm going to give you 8 tips to get the most out of the budget-priced audio interface, the Behringer Euphoria UM2. Plus, I've got one bonus tip, but you'll have to stick around to the end to find that out, and it just might be one of the most important tips out of them all. I put a link to the Behringer UM2 in the video description below, just in case you want to see the latest pricing and see the full specs of this audio interface. But right now, let's get started with the tips. Tip 1. Install the actual Behringer driver for the UM2. I know if you go to the website, it tells you to install the ASIO for All driver, but Behringer actually had their own driver for it, and I did a video on how to install it. There should be a card up here, and the link is also below if you want to click on that and check it out. The downloads for those drivers are also in that video description. Tip 2. Set your streaming software to mono or record to a mono track. If you installed the driver from tip 1, you may notice that you're only hearing audio out of one side, usually it's the left side. This is because each input on the UM2 is actually a mono source. So if you record to a stereo track, it's only going to record to one side. I did a couple of videos on how to do this in Audacity and OBS. Again, they're linked in the description below. Tip 3. To use the phantom power on the Behringer UM2, you must use an XLR to XLR cable, not an XLR to quarter inch cable. Even though the line input and the XLR input share the same location, it is actually two separate inputs on the inside, and only the XLR input carries the phantom power. Tip 4. When using your Behringer UM2, make sure it's away from other electrical cables or other electronic devices like USB mice, keyboards, your cell phone, even sometimes your laptop or your computer case can cause interference. And this is because the plastic case of the Behringer UM2 doesn't do the greatest job at shielding it from electronic interference. If you start noticing some weird noises in the interface, like bad ground sorts of noises or other kind of interference coming in, it's likely because you have it too close to some other device. Tip 5 is choosing your sample rate. Now, this can be more of a preference thing for advanced users, but if you're just new to audio recording, a good rule of thumb is to choose 44,100 for recording music and choosing 48,000 for recording video. And this is because 44,100 is CD quality and it's pretty standard for music playback software. And 48,000 is DVD quality and that's pretty standard for video work. Tip 6 is know which input you're going to connect your devices to. So if you're connecting a microphone, connect it to the XLR input using an XLR cable. If you're connecting a synthesizer, an external mixer, or a CD player, or some sort of external audio device, you want to use the line input right here. If you're connecting a bass guitar or guitar, you're going to want to use the instrument input right here. Unless you have active pickups, then you can use the line input. Tip 7 is if you have speakers or monitors connected to the Behringer UM2, you'll want to turn the volume down on the actual speakers or turn them right off when recording or streaming. This one might seem a little bit obvious, but some beginners might get a surprise dose of feedback if they try to record or stream with their speakers on. And this is because the output volume controls both the headphones and the speaker volume. Tip 8 is you can actually use Pro Tools with the Behringer UM2 and get great results. Now, this is a preference tip, but if you're new to recording and you want to get to know the software that Pro Studios use, you can actually download a free version of Pro Tools called Pro Tools First, and you can get started in the Pro Tools world. Actually, let me know what software you currently use in the comments below. We've done all 8 tips already, so now it's time to do that bonus tip that I told you about. And this is, get used to the interface that you have. Unless your interface is broken or you need more inputs, don't think that upgrading to some other interface is going to instantly make your content sound better. The truth is, unless you spend a significant amount on an audio interface, I'm talking at least $500, but likely more, you're really not going to notice any sort of audible difference with the audio that you're recording. The AD-DA converters in all of the lower priced audio interfaces is going to be very similar. You'll be better off investing in a higher end microphone or instrument that will give you instantly noticeable results. The better you know your audio interface, the better quality recordings you're going to get. And like I said, unless the thing breaks or you need more inputs, there really isn't a need to upgrade it unless you're going to be spending a significant amount of money. The Behringer UM2 will give you CD quality audio and broadcast quality audio. This video up here is what YouTube thinks you'll like next, and this one down here is my Behringer UM2 playlist. If you enjoyed this video and would like to see more like it, please consider subscribing to the channel and give this one a big thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Radio Zane, and we'll see you in the next video.